In this demonstration, we are going to show an application disaster recovery from an on-premise Kubernetes cloud to one in AWS, leveraging
Cloud Block Store
and the ability of Pure Service Orchestrator to import volumes into Kubernetes Management Control that have been created outside of the Kubernetes cluster. Here we see a simple deployment of Minio, the S3-compatible cloud storage server in an on-premise Kubernetes cluster, where the persistent storage in the deployment is being provided by a volume on a physical Pure Storage Flash Array. We can see from the Flash Array GUI that the Kubernetes persistent volume has been added to a protection group called Kubernetes Minio. This is configured for replication every 5 minutes to a target. In this case, the target is a
Cloud Block Store
in AWS. The protection group can be created and the volume added to it using simple Ansible playbooks rather than using the FlashArray GUI, thereby increasing operational simplicity of your whole deployment. Going back to the Minio browser, I'm now going to add a new file to the solution, one we've already got ready, and we'll just let that upload. Now this has been successfully uploaded, I'm now going to simulate a failure of the Kubernetes cluster by deleting my Minio deployment in the Kubernetes GUI. We'll just make sure that's completely gone. Okay, so that deployment is now gone. Now we're going to move over to one of the nodes that is in the AWS Kubernetes cluster. You see here we've got a simple script. It's going to interrogate the
Cloud Block Store
to get the latest snapshot name from the replication group that we'd set up. And it's going to pass that information to an Ansible playbook. The Ansible playbook uses a native Flash Array module called pgsnap. That will take a copy of the snapshot and create a full read-write copy called Minio Recover. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use that Minio Recover volume, and using this annotation that's available within Pure Service Orchestrator, we're going to bring that Minio Recover volume into the control of Kubernetes. At that point, we're going to run a standard Minio deployment YAML file that will then pick up this new PVC that's been created from Minio Recover, and we'll have our recovered environment. So let's run the recover script to get the information and to create the new Minio volume. Now we're going to do a kubectl. And we're going to create the new PVC from that replicated copy. And now we're going to go over to create a deployment. That deployment's been created. What we'll do now is to go on to the Kubernetes cluster, see the new deployment for Minio spinning up. And that's now spun up, 11 seconds, obviously. And if we go into there, we'll be able to see a pod that's been created. And here is a new persistent volume claim. This volume was created by Kubernetes from that Minio deployment, Minio recover volume. Again, that was done using the Pure Service Orchestrator controls. We'll go now onto the Minio browser and refresh that. Okay, so that's all good. So what we've now seen in this demonstration, you can enable disaster recovery between two Kubernetes clusters using Pure Service Orchestrator and replication between two flash arrays, one a traditional physical array and the other a virtual instance based in the public cloud.